You might have been in a situation where you get so nervous you underperform on a test, or you forget the words for a speech, or you freeze well in public even though you have practiced a dance 100 times. The last one is commonly known as a scenic panic, and there are tons of strategies out there that you can use to overcome it. But for the other two, we don't have as many resources to help us understand what's going on and how to overcome it in the long run. So today I will teach you what is an emotional filter and how to rewire your learning around it. We can informally define an emotional filter as an accumulation of our insecurities and our beliefs, like our age, gender, race, etc. You can think of it as a tunnel that stands in between us and our final learning goal. And it can be either positive and serve its function, or be negative and block your way. Taking my struggles with Korean as an example, we can say that the emotional filter stands in between the version of me who knows Korean and the version of me who can speak Korean. If I have good beliefs about myself, it becomes positive and I can use my knowledge to speak mostly flawlessly. But if I have insecurities related to speaking, it becomes negative and I freeze because the information doesn't reach its destination. Teachers work with this by encouraging the students and providing them with a safe space to make mistakes along with other techniques. It is tough, and it can be tougher when you're learning on your own and you don't even know where to start. It can lead to not being motivated and drop out, or even having panic attacks as soon as you open a book or into a classroom. So the first thing we need to understand is that this is a phenomenon based in our identities and the state of mind that we have at the time. It is driven by our emotions, so we need to identify which insecurities or beliefs are making it stay negative. Knowing the source, we can use strategies like creating an alter ego or reevaluating our motivations to tackle it and make it work as a tunnel again. Hold on, let me put some emotional music. My emotional filter with Korean comes from feeling accepted. I usually feel anxious when I'm close to Korean people in person, and I also get nervous when I see written Korean in a chat. It's taken me some time to try to understand which insecurities or beliefs are playing a role in it. And so far I can say I feel pressured to fit in. I've had a hard time fitting in ever since I was little. I always had different interests, different motivations, and different hobbies, which made people label me as a weird kid. When I started learning more about the Korean culture, I realized there were so many aspects of it that made me feel identified, and I got excited because I hadn't felt like that, not even with my own culture. So I started dreaming of going to school in Korea, working there, living there. But seeing so many foreigners sharing bad experiences while being in Korea made me feel scared, and without realizing it, I tried to change myself into this new version of me who I believe will be more accepted by Koreans. I didn't want to move to another continent and realized I was also the weird kid there, because I finally felt there was a place where I could fit in, and that meant a lot to me. I was just so pressured to be someone perfect for them that it slowly got very dark and I completely forgot everything I love about the culture, the amazing things that people are capable of doing, and everything good I could find in there. I felt like I was being evaluated by an ominous Korean deity anytime I used the language to make sure I was fit to live among them. Okay, end of the emotional segment. So the next step after you understand what is making your emotional filter stay negative is to go back to the basics. You need to find something that you like within the culture of your target language, even if it is small or looks insignificant. That way you are able to build motivation through curiosity and connect with the culture, which is the richest source of information to learn a language. I talk about this in more detail in my previous video in case you want to see some examples as well. The last step is to make a study plan that aligns with your goals, motivations, and your current needs. Be flexible about it because we're constantly growing and changing. So the plan that works now may not work in 6 months. And that's okay, because that means we can make the learning experience always a positive and friendly one for us. Start from zero anytime you need to make sure there's always a clean, fresh take. The truth is I haven't overcome the fear that's in my emotional filter, nor the lack of motivation that came later. But while experimenting with some techniques and resources, I have been able to slowly start tackling my lack of motivation and even improve my pronunciation in Korean. And I hope through making use of all this information, I can greet you from Korea in a very close future. Now tell me, do you also struggle with a negative emotional filter? I'll read you in the comments. Thank you for watching. See you next time.